not going to believe this next story. He walks our streets wearing a mask and even a cape. Tonight, News says Eric Flack introduces us to the man who calls himself Cincinnati's superhero.
He calls himself the Shadow Hare, a man who patrols the streets of Cincinnati to try and stop crime and clean up the city. And he's not alone. Dressed like a professional wrestler with a cape, Shadow Hare is actually a 21-year-old from Milford, although that's all he would tell us about his identity. He says he was abused as a child, grew up in foster homes, and now has dedicated his life to helping others.
Well, since when has Cincinnati had one great hero?
Shadow Hare is actually part of a growing community of citizen crime fighters from around the country.
Like a Cliptico from Pennsylvania, Wall Creeper from Colorado, Master Legend from Florida, Mr. Extreme in California.
Most of them belong to a website called the World Superhero Registry and often travel in teams. Shadow Hare leads a group he calls the Allegiance of Heroes.
Allegiance, assemble! We help enforce the law by doing what we can in legal standards. So we carry handcuffs, tasers, pepper spray, all the legal weapons. We will do citizens' arrests, and we will intervene on crimes if there is one happening in front of us.
But in the real world, superheroes don't always win. Shadow Hare says he suffered a dislocated shoulder trying to help a woman who was being attacked a couple years ago. And although he sees himself as the eyes and ears of police...
If there's anything that I can do, please give me a call, all right?
All right, baby.
All right, catch you later.
Shadow Hare and his team don't exactly strike fear in the faces of criminals or anyone else who saw them walking around Cincinnati earlier this month.
Spider-Man, that's what they look like. Homemade Spider-Man.
What the heck is this, man? This ain't Easter.
But it's no joke to the men and women behind the masks, although some of the things that came out of Shadow Hare's mouth couldn't help but make us laugh a little.
He surely won't recognize us because he's blind, but I'm sure he'll recognize the taste of a good meal, wouldn't you say?
Still, Shadow Hare hopes that as word spreads about what he's doing, others will join his cause. In the meantime, his team stands alone, believing in their mission, even if no one else does.
My message to Cincinnati is that there is still hope, and all we have to do is stand together.
As for how legal all this is, citizens' arrests are allowed in Ohio and Kentucky for felonies and some misdemeanors, although the person making the citizens' arrest risks lawsuits or possible criminal charges of their own if they're wrong about the person they're accusing. Eric Flack, News 5.
All right. I guess he's at least trying, Eric. Thanks so much. By the way, Cincinnati police say they don't know enough about the Shadow Hare to say if what he's doing is good or bad, but they do say that citizens on patrol groups have been very helpful in fighting crime.